Hi, everybody. This is Crystal Proxmire of Oakland County Times, and we're here today with Michael Carson, who's running for Keego Harbor City Council. How are you today?
I'm doing well. Thank you for having me.
Well, thanks for doing this. Can you tell us why you've decided to run for council?
Yeah, I've lived in the city for about 7 years, and I'm really passionate about our city. I would like to get on the council to make sure there's transparency in government. I would also like to look at long-term strategic planning for the city, as well as to make sure that everyone is represented.
So what are some of those specific things that you'd like to work on?
Well, of course, I want to make sure that our city is safe. I'd like to look at the staffing of the police department and make sure that we have enough officers on the road, and that's going well. I also would like to look at the overall plan for the city, not just pieces of the city that are getting improved, but an overall plan for the entire city to make sure that there's all-encompassing plan that makes sure that the entire city moves forward at the same time.
So can you tell us a bit about your professional experience and what skills you bring to the table?
Sure. Start with education. I am currently working on my doctorate degree. I'll be complete in April of 22. I have a master's in business administration, which I had now for a number of years, and also a bachelor's degree in health administration, gerontology. Professional experience, starting with an elected position, I was on the Walled Lake Consolidated Board of Education for 12 and a half years. And at that time, I served as president, vice president, and secretary of the board, as well as trustee, and felt that I brought great value to the educational system. And I was committed to making it better and not making it worse, and leaving it hopefully better than when I found it. And I feel good about that. My professional life, I am the president and CEO of the Area Agency on Aging 1B. We cover 6 counties in the state of Michigan, from Monroe to St. Clair. And we are an organization, a nonprofit organization, that was established by an act of Congress in the late 60s, early 70s. And we care for elderly and adults with disabilities. We have over 200 staff, and we perform a tremendous amount of functions to really allow people to live home and as independent as possible. While most people have not heard of our program, the one thing that they've always heard of is Meals on Wheels. We don't create the meals, but we do contract with different people throughout our 6 counties to create the meals, manufacture the meals, deliver them to people's homes, and we have a high amount of oversight. We do everything from programs keeping people in their home, helping them with activities of daily living, to exercise programs, adult daycare, a wide variety of programs that we do. We're very proud of that. I've been in healthcare almost my entire career, and I'm also a part-time police officer for the city of Sylvan Lake, and I've been there for about 4 or 5 years as well.
So what are some of the other ways that you've been involved in the community?
Well, I think, you know, working a lot, obviously, been involved in the community. What we do is, as a nonprofit, is really care for the community. I am on the SEMCOG board as a member at large. I am on the board, community board also for a hospital system. So I do a lot of that type of thing. And then I'm on another board in Lansing for seniors as well. It's an association. And in doing so, obviously doing police work, it's a passion to make sure that our cities are safe, that our cities are well patrolled, that people can enjoy our cities and make sure that they're enjoying it without worrying about their safety of their property or themselves. And of course, Orchard Lake, Keego Harbor, and Sylvan Lake all work collaboratively together. So I feel that I've really had a life of giving back to our communities. And I'd like to continue that as a city council person for Keego Harbor.
So in this race, there is some competition for these positions. Why should the voters pick you?
Well, a tremendous amount of experience that I bring to the table, a passion for what I do and what I would also help bring forward for the city, as well as a new set of eyes, someone who has not been there, someone who might not be part of the mainstream of the people that have been sitting there. So new ideas, a new fresh look, and a very transparent person on the council.
So if the residents want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
Well, you know, I'm just in the process of getting started. Happy to say that I had a semester or my midterm break So I had semester break for school, which has given me a lot more time. I will start going door to door and get some printed material as well as some signs. And in doing so, I hope to meet more people. And I plan on going to meetings as well as they're, if they're held public and they're not virtual. So I'm going to try to get out more, meet more people. I have been doing that. I have a lot of support already, grassroots support in the community. And I'm hoping to have that grow as I meet people throughout the entire city.
Great. Well, thank you so much for taking the time to do the interview with us today.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure being with you, and thank you for having me as part of your show.